The construction of Arua Airfield into an international airport is financed 80% by UK Export Finance and 15% by Commercial Source Standard Chartered Bank. The value of the contract is €309.1 million, of which €264.1 million is for construction of the airfield into an international airport. Build, operate and transfer model is used to finance large projects, typical infrastructure projects developed through public-private partnership. Minister Katumba also revealed that the MOU was signed after the approval by the Solicitor General, and Miss East of Eden is to undertake the feasibility study. The move to develop Arua Airfield into an international airport has been welcomed by the leaders in Arua City.
We had a meeting with the investors from East of Eden. They came to make an assessment of the airport. They want to invest in upgrading the airport, and we welcomed them. As you know, we are desperately in need of the development of that facility. We needed it yesterday. So we are enthusiastic because the development of this airport will come with so many benefits.
The Land Committee Chairman, Arua City, Bernard Atiku, who is also the former Member of Parliament for Aivu County, commends government for finally finding funding source for the airport upgrade. He said it has been 2 decades for the government to fix the construction of Arua Airfield into an international airport.
Instead of the airport remaining in the state in which it has been for decades, it's better the airport is developed and utilized. In any case, somebody is supposed to benefit from that investment. We have seen situations where government has built airports but outsourced its operations or management. So if the same can also be done for management of international airport infrastructure, so be it.
The former legislator said the airport in Arua is long overdue, and this will reduce the rate of unemployment and improve household income and provide market for the people. Atiku is optimistic that the investor will ensure quality work done based on the build, operate and transfer model.
The airport in Arua is long overdue, and I'm very sure once it is completed, it will create job opportunities. The rate of unemployment in our region will go down, and the economy of this region will grow. Our people will have their household income will improve. The people who will be traveling into the region will give market for our people, because they'll come here to eat. They'll come here for leisure.
In July 2009, Civil Aviation Authority, that owns and operates Arua Airfield, publicly announced that it had started to upgrade the airport to international standards. The plans included a modern airport terminal with capacity for 200 passengers, paving the runway, widening it to 45 meters, about 148 feet, and extending it to 2.5 kilometers, about 8,200 feet. However, these plans were delayed because of compensation process. In 2016, government released the ceiling $6.5 billion to compensate people, but about 5 people complained to government of undervaluation of their properties, whose concerns have been considered. Arua Airfield is the second busiest domestic airport in the country after Entebbe, with a monthly average of 180 air traffic movements. A report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.